Hi, everyone. I can get this in correctly. This is an art journal daily, art every day hashtag event that I need to get the name of it straight. And this is from an art group by Peg Robinson, and she is hosting this hashtag event. I'm so happy to be here. This is my first hashtag event that I've been invited to, and it's just awesome. I'm going to use some of these metallic colors that I bought a while ago, and I just hadn't used them because I thought I wouldn't know how, which is what I always think, and you should take a lesson from me about that and know that as long as you put your brush to the paper, the result of that will come out. And so I'm loving that part. This is metallic paint by Craftsmart. It is, I don't know what the name is. All I know is it is gorgeous blue. I'll call it gorgeous blue. And this one was silver. First one was metallic black, sequin black or something like that. That one is labeled. Then we have a beautiful metallic purple. So I'm going to start off with these colors, and this is going to be an art page that is basically something I've been doing for a few days here, and I'm just literally taking inspiration from my own art. This is Do Art Every Day, and it is to promote making a habit of doing art every day. And that's what the reason for the hashtag event is. So I'm just going to kind of load up my brush here and go from there, see what comes out. I hope you had a happy Halloween. I have to say that I don't really, here in our neighborhood, the church that I go to down at the intersection near me, they host what they call a fall festival. And it is where all the children go basically for Halloween. Celebration. All the children go there for with their costumes, and it's very fun. So I did not have one trick-or-treater last night. And that's the trend here in Phoenix, is we have not been having very many trick-or-treaters, and I feel really bad for the people across the street because she's a window designer for a department store here, and she is so talented, and she just decorates her front yard and side yard all the way up to the front of the house with beautiful decorations, actually for every holiday, not just Halloween. And also a very talented lady. I really enjoy my neighborhood. It's a mature neighborhood with trees that drape over the street, and I'm gonna go on a walk. I went on a walk earlier in the year, but I'm gonna go on another walk that will take us down to the park. I love the park that's near here. I'm gonna move this up a bit because I want to make sure that I'm in frame. Yeah, now I am. Okay, so I've got some images here. This is supposed to be 15 minutes of art a day. I don't know if I will make that, but that's okay. I'm just going to take inspiration from some of these images that I got from a Pier 1 magazine, and honestly they are just gorgeous. Look at that one. So I'm just going to use some of these as is. I might go around the top of this one here a little bit more. I'm not a fussy cutter, so this is about as close to fussy cutting as I get. So I really don't enjoy fussy cutting. If I am sitting in front of the TV, and it could be a mindless activity. I've never done that, so I might be able to tolerate it a little bit more if I actually did that. So this is a pumpkin, but it's got all kinds of other things around it. And I'm just going to kind of lay it in the corner here. But not with a whole lot of glue. I'm just going to use a little bit of this tacky glue, my favorite glue, right here. It's not quite as wet as Elmer's. Elmer's glue is my second favorite. But I have not, I haven't had Elmer's glue exactly that name brand for a long time. I've been using Dollar Tree glue. And that one turns out okay. Looks like I got a little bit of something or other on there. I can go over that a little later. Okay, so these are the index cards that I have made for a swap or two, challenge or two, I think. And I'm just looking to use some of those colors. I would like to use this orange, which is really called salmon. And I really love this color. Color. So, let's see. I think gold. This is gold. It appears to be gold. It doesn't have a name on it. It has I don't even see a number, and I'm not going to worry about it either. A little bit of gold swirlies. And I just want my homemade art materials. Let's see here. Not sure how thick that metallic paint is. I am getting a blend, so that's okay. I'll get a blend. Love this. So 15 minutes of art a day, guys. And I'm gonna get a little bit more gold and not mix it, because it doesn't seem very thick. So I just have this little thimble. This is a thimble. People, I don't see people using thimbles. I always use them because my fingers hurt. See how that goes. And I'm just going to add, sorry for my nose, I'm just going to add a little bit of stenciling here. Let's see if I can do it right. I love how it looks, but I'm just not very good at it yet, so I just need to practice more. That's not turning out much. A little bit, not very much though. Sorry. So that means that I'm going to go to my next one, that is one of my favorite types of, this is like from Dollar Tree, and it's a non-skid mat that I just kind of tear it up and I go from there. Let's see if this makes any kind of impression. A little bit. I think it's just the paint. And I'm thinking, does everything I do have to turn out to be the grand experiment in my life? No, it doesn't. didn't make a lot of difference. So I'm just gonna go right on into some gesso sprinkles. Gesso sprinkles. Oops. The noise we love to hate. The weather here has finally turned into autumn. I'm so happy. It is, this may not seem like autumn to other people, but this is full on autumn to people here. It's in the 80s during the day and goes down to maybe 50 or 60 at night. And I love this time of year. This time of year, we call them snowbirds. This is why people come here. I need to do this off my painting so that I get the right, kind of the right type of splatters before I put it onto my painting. And I really like the finer type of splatters. I know that a lot of people like the bigger ones like that. But this is what I like for it to look like. So there we go. I'm just gonna wipe the side of that one off so I don't have to put it in the... We may have a bark alert here pretty soon. I'm getting low growls from my little one that is sitting here by me. Okay, so these are the final leaves from this gorgeous package that I've been working from of leaves, and I just want to put them over here at the bottom of this pumpkin. So that it kind of tricks the eye and lets us think that this is a whole pumpkin and not a part one. I don't know. I'll have to put some more stuff in there. So there we go. I think that's about 15 minutes worth of art today, and I don't know, maybe I'll just cut out one of these for a leaf. Because they already have some leaves over here. So I'll just put that down. Here we go. I'm loving this. This is going to be the cover to my hashtag art every day journal. And for the month of November, this is for the month of November, this little hashtag event. It's a major hashtag event. It's my major hashtag event that was started by Peg Robinson, and she's a part of the Joy of Art Facebook group, and I will do my best to put that in the whatever it's called, the down part underneath of the video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. If you're watching this video, please subscribe and thumbs up, and I love your sweet comments. Talk to you later.